Hello my dear students, welcome all of you in our PPS video lecture series. And in a previous lectures we are completed the string concept and some inbuilt functions of string, and now today we will see more about in our practical session how it works. Clear? So first, the practical title is just like the demonstrate the use of inbuilt functions of string like strlen, cpy, cat and much more. Clear? Now if you remember, in our previous lectures we have seen all the functions, but they are provided in which header files? In a string.h. so first header file is always stdio.h, but now we have to include the another header files, that is string.h. so right here has include second header file, that is string.h. so all the inbuilt functions of regarding string will be available in this library. Then after, remember the declaration of string, and for that string we have to compulsorily pass the data type like character, because the string is nothing but the collection of characters. And one string we required here, suppose I am taken the first practical to find the length of given string, then only one string we needed, and the name of it is s, and the size, that is suppose 10. After declaring string, now we have to initialize the value, and there is two method, compile time and run time, and we are using runtime initialization always. So in a printf we have to write enter string. Now there are two different functions, scanf and gets, but we are not using scanf functions because it doesn't support any space character. Clear? So the inbuilt function for a string is gets, that accept all the letters including space. So use getS function, and inside getS we have to write the string name, that is s again. So this is about the declaration and initialization. Now we have to find the length, and length is always in a integer, and for that we have to declare one variable integer l, and the syntax for a length function is l equal strlen. Inside len function we have to pass just the string name, that is s. Now print this value of l using printf function. So in a printf we are writing like length of string equal percentage d, because the length is in a integer and the value of l. Clear? So this is about the finding length. Now execute this program, compile it. There is no error, so you can directly run it. Message is just like enter string, and suppose I enter my name Bhumi, then what happened? The length of string equals 6 will be display. Clear? Now see the another function, that is strcpy. Now here we want two string to copy from one string to another, and for that we are just change here the name, instead of s, s1 for first string and s2 for a second string. Clear? So here put just the string name s1. Now what is the syntax? So first we have to read one string that we are getting using getS function. And now put the logic of using function strcpy. Inside this bracket we have to write two string. So first is always s2 and second is always s1. Why? Because the right hand side string will be copied in a left hand side. So right hand side is our s1, that is our original string, and that will be copied in a s2, and that value we want to print. So for that we have to use printf function, and inside printf we are writing just message copied string equal percentage s and the value of s2. Clear? Now see the output of this program, compile it and run it. Enter string, same here I am typing my name. So the length equals 6 and the copied string is Bhumi. So the original data will be copied in a S2. Now move to the next program. That is, suppose strcat. CAT stands for concatenation, means combine two string. So here just we are using function, that is strcat, and inside it again we have to write two string, suppose that is s1 comma s2, and print the message. In a printf we have to write combine string equal percentage s, and the value of which we have to find, the left hand side is always our answer. So here the left hand side is s1, so we have to write s1. So in that case, check the output. First compile it, then just put here the /n, so you can get all the output in a different line. Now run this program, enter string. So here suppose I am enter Bhumi. So the length is 6, copied string is Bhumi, and the combined string is what? 2 times Bhumi. So the second string, that is S2, will be combined with S1. Clear? Now check for a next function, that is strcmp. The full form is for comparison of two string. So here the two string we want to read from the user, and for that we have to use gets function again. So here just I am change the message like enter string s1, and then again after gets we have to write in a printf enter string s2. Which function we want? Get s to read the second string, that is s2. So two string now we want to read from the user, and the first logic is for finding length, second is for a copy, and third is for a combined two string. Clear? And now we want to compare two string. So for that we have to write the if condition and then strcmp function for comparison. And two string we want to pass s1 comma s2. Equal equal 0 indicates what? If this condition is true, means both the strings difference is 0, that indicates both are same. So just we have to print the message in a printf both are equal. But suppose this condition is false, then we have to go for a else part, and inside else we have to write like printf both are not equal. Clear? So this is the logic. Now what happened when we are executing this program? Now our s2 will be changed. In a previous example the s2 is same, my name Bhumi, because we are copying first the s1 data in a s2 and then we are combining, but now our s2 is changed, so our output is also changed in this program. So run this program again, compile it and run it. So here see the message, enter string s1, and suppose I enter first string, that is hello, and second string is suppose friend. Then what happened? First find the length of s1, that is 5, so the length equals 5. Copied string equals what? The s1 is copied in a s2, so again it prints hello. Then third, combined string equals what? Hello, hello. And then the message is just like both are not equal. So what happened here? The S1 is only hello and S2 is changed, that is 2 time hello, hello. So in that case the both the strings are not equal. So for that now we are changing in our program to understand it better, here we are taken comment and only we are using this logic. So put the comment line for a length, copy and concat. Just use the comparison for better understanding how it will work. So execute this program again. Enter string S1. So simply I am putting hello and then S2, suppose student. Then the both the strings are not equal. You can see here the both are same. No, because the H and S both are compared first and the first difference we are getting not equal. So they move not onwards and just display the message both are not equal. Clear? The again we are run this program for a same string, just like enter my name in a first string and second string, suppose I enter my name but it is in a caps lock, then in that case what happen? It is same or not same? Again it is a not same. The message is both are not equal. Why? So if you remember, the ASCII value of small b and capital B both are difference. So in that case, if the both the letters are same, then also we are finding the difference is not zero. So to overcome this type of problem, we have another function, that is strcmpi. So just put simply I here after cmp, and now this I meaning is what? It ignores the uppercase and lowercase. So if you are writing letters in a capital or a small, it now becomes same. So check the same program, compile it and then run it. First string is in a small letter my name, and then S2 is in a capital letters. So here you find the answer both are equals. So as per your requirement, you can use any of the logic. Again we have another functions for a strcmp, that is strncmp, that we are already discussed in our theory. What happened? Now in this case we have to use third parameter, that is value of n, and suppose here I am writing 3. So how many characters it compare? Only the 3 character of both the strings will be compared. So let's check the same program, compile it and run this program. So here the string S1, suppose I am entering my name Bhumi, and second that is BHUMI. Then what happened? First letter is same, second letter is same, but the third O and U both are different. So in that case you are finding the message like both are not equal. But suppose you are compare when only 2 values. So instead of 3, if you putting here just 2, then you are finding the answer both are same. Clear? Now similar function you can see for strncmp, strncat, that we are already discussed. Now move onwards to the next functions, that is strrev. So just put the comment line here. And use the logic for a reverse, and that is the function strrev. Which value you want to reverse, S1 or S2? Here 2 strings are there. So suppose I am enter S1. So the first string will be reversed. Clear? And the message we have to display in a printf, reverse string equal %s. And the value of S1. So here no need of S2. So again put it in a comment. Clear? Now execute this program, compile it first, run it, enter string S1, and suppose I enter my name, then it becomes reverse. Clear? Now see here the another functions, that is strchr, that is not discussed in our previous theory part. For that we have to use the strchr functions, and in that functions we have to put two things. First is a string and second is a character. So here our string is h1, and which character you want to find from your string? Suppose I want to find character x. So you have to write that character in a single inverted, because this function is used to find the character from the string. Now what happened when you are writing this function? It returns yes or no, means null or not null value. So it is again in a if part. So here you have to write in a if the same function, that is strchr s1 comma x, and then equal null. You can write null in a capital letters also, or you can simply put null in a single inverted slash zero. Clear? And inside if, print the message printf character is not found. The meaning is what? If this condition is true, means we are getting null value. That means the x is not present in our string. But suppose we are getting not null value, that indicates our character is present. Clear? So execute this program. First compile it and run it. The message is just like enter string s1. And suppose I am enter and that is my name, Bhume. Then what happened? The answer is display. The character is not found because in my name the x is not present. The similar functions to find the string from another string. Clear? And that is here you have to change like str. Now x is only single inverted because it is single character, and for that we are using strchr. Now the function is changed, so we have to put in a double inverted multiple values, and that is suppose xyz. So what is the meaning of this? The str function is used to find the substring from the original string, and the same way it works. So here if the s1 has a value xyz, then it returns null value or not null value? It returns not null value. Clear? But here our condition is just like s1 comma xyz equals null, means our s1 does not contain xyz. So here the message is just like string is not found. Clear? Now execute this program, compile it and run it. And suppose here the string is same my name, then the output is string is not found because xyz is not present. So likewise that this all the functions you can use. If you remember this all the types of problems we are searching in our Excel. Suppose in Excel you are finding some characters, or if you want to find some string, also you can find some number, it is present or not in our list, then you can write this type of logic. So string functions here are completed. I hope you guys understand this string inbuilt functions. If you like this video, then thumbs up. If you think this video will help some of your friends, then do share this video with them. Also, you can subscribe my channel, so when I upload new video, you get a notifications. Thank you for listening.